about the job the firefighters are doing out in Calabasas. That was amazing.
It's amazing, those guys, man. All respect out to all those firefighters out there, man. Thanks for everything you guys are doing, and thanks for keeping our homes safe and people safe.
It was the worst fire in California history.
It's crazy, man. I saw a lot of video. I've been watching it pretty close because, it's out by my house.
Yeah.
Got evacuated. So, yeah, so keep an eye on the whole thing. It's been crazy watching everything.
Did you take anything when you got evacuated? Anything with you?
I was already gone when we got evacuated. I was training down south, so wasn't able to grab much. I got my family out, though, so we're good. Everything else can be replaced.
That's
so
true.
Good.
As far as you know, your house is okay?
I had a friend send me a picture 2 days ago, and it was still standing. I think the fire got about a quarter mile from the house. But I don't think it made it. As of now, it hasn't made it. They lifted the
evacuation
now, so after this, we might go check it out real quick.
But hopefully everything's good.
We hope so.
So did you keep working out, though, obviously to a certain degree, but just not as hard as an actual real fight camp?
Did I keep working? Yeah, I'm still working out. I never stop. I'm a martial artist.
Right.
I'll always be training. But, I wasn't training as regular as I would if I had a fight team or fight camp.
Right.
Even like when I was fighting off season, I just wanted to take a lot of time off. But I'd be back in the gym next week.
Right.
Helping other guys get ready for fights.
Yeah.
Glover.
Right.
Or Scott Lighty.
Mm-hmm.
I'd be in there sparring with them. And just I come in a week after my fight and go spar with them. I'd be done after that. Okay, I'm done sparring. I'm out. But,
right.
But I'd still be back in the gym. So I was away from that, but I've always done things active and moving around. And I like training with guys. I like helping guys get ready.
Yeah. I feel like going back into wrestling, though, would be tough, I feel like that part, you'd be like, oh, okay, stand-up's fun, but getting back on the mat and just grinding out on wrestling, I think it'd be hard.
I love jiu-jitsu. I love training the ground. It's still one of the most interesting parts. It's such a chess game down there. Without the striking, it becomes even more of a chess game down there. Those guys, they're doing all sorts of stuff. Pretty crazy.
Chuck, when you were a kid, who's the one fighter you looked up to the most?
When I was a kid, I love Hagler. Hagler was fun to watch. I love all those guys. That division was amazing back then.
Durant, Sugar Ray Leonard.
Hearns, Gabby. That was a bad division back then. But then, obviously, grew up watching Tyson. Tyson pay-per-views, watching him. Don't blink, you'll miss it.
Do you have any favorite Tyson moment?
No, I don't know. I'd have to think about that.
He's a fun dude.
What?
He's a fun guy.
Oh, no, he's a great guy. I think for me, just walking out, Light, Bellagio. He came up, and I was with some of my friends, and walking by his table, and he invited us to sit at his table and have a few drinks with him, and my buddy couldn't stop talking about the rest of it. He still talks about it today. So that was probably the coolest moment with him.
So Chuck Liddell is about to work out, guys. Right here, he's getting ready for Tito Ortiz. The fight is November 24th at the Forum. Thank you.
We're good.
I love that.
We're good, man. That's right.
I'm sure you've really missed all the media stuff too, right? This is your favorite part, right?
No, actually, I don't mind it. That media week, the week of the fight, you know, because I've already done all my work, and you know, it's a part of me. So I have fun with it. I don't take it too serious at this point. You know, I just kind of goof around. I have fun with the. I've always had fun with the media, goofing off. And,
well, we appreciate it.
Yeah, I mean, it's not. I think out of this time, it gets more serious. Get more serious conversations. At this point, I'm just goofing off. I'm in that mode anyway. I'm just kind of goofy, having fun. I'm happy.
So I think Tito's going to scout you out on this workout. He's hanging out. He's staying in the building.
That's all right.
I'm sure you've been asked a million times, but why are the toenails painted?
You haven't heard that one? That's a long story.
I've been stuck in boxing too many years.
You know, it started in 04. I did it as a joke. I was walking through a mall with a girl that I was with, and she was getting a pedicure, and she's like, hey, why don't you get one too while you're waiting? Your feet are disgusting. I got Fred Flintstone feet. So we go in the mall, and so I went to get a pedicure, and at the end, the girl joked with me, like, what color do you want? I started laughing. I'm like, okay, because some of the guys on my team have been trying to get me to paint my nails. They're punk kids. And they paint their nails. So I was like, you know, actually, let's do it. Paint them all black. I go, you know, no, actually, I'm not going to give in all the way. Paint the big ones pink. So the big toes are pink. And the little ones are black. And took some pictures, sent it to everybody, forgot about it, laughed, did all the thing. Okay, so 2 weeks later, fast forward, I'm at a Charger game. We're gonna go. My friend Lorenzo Neal played for the Chargers at the time, and Kasim Osgood was going to watch a play. I'm walking around, and people keep coming up to me, going, "They look at me. They look down at my feet, look at me crazy," and they go, and I walk off. And so, about halftime, I'm like, "What did my brother? What the hell is wrong with people today? Why are people being so weird?" My brother goes, "Chuck, look at your feet." Now, I never had my toes painted. I didn't know you had to take it off. Never thought about it. I looked down, oh, man. Now it makes sense. But the reactions I got from people from then on was so funny to me. I just kept doing it. I've done it ever since. And then
14 years.
I do it with my daughter. I've been doing it since 2004.
You had friends in high school on the wrestling team used to do it because they said it would distract the guys to look down while in the middle of a match. Like, why does this dude have painted nails? And I kind of helped to throw them off. So.
Yeah, it's funny. It was fun. The reaction I got from people were just so funny. Like, well, I mean, the worst I get from guys is, well, I guess you can.
They're not going to fight about it.
Yeah, I guess you can if you want.
Are you painting yourself or you have help?
I have help.
Okay.
Yeah, no, I don't.
How's your technique?
I get numb. I'm sound pretty terrible. If I didn't, you'd know.
They are. Especially painting, like, for me, like, painting my own left hand, because I'm left-handed.